Hi everybody, you are watching Tutorials. My name is Alex and in this tutorial I'm gonna show you how to design this label for pharmaceutical or supplement product in Adobe Illustrator, and then I will show you how to present it to your client. So this will be both Adobe Illustrator and Photoshop tutorial, and we are going to design a very comprehensive scene. First of all, we are going to design the first kind of like face of our product, the label, and the face is the scene that sells, so we are putting emphasis on it. Who cares about the supplement fact or barcode section? And then I will show you how to create the similar options for your client to pick from, right? So you need to always pre-create some options, and in this tutorial we are going to create at least three options for this label. So let's get started in Adobe Illustrator from the new document. Control N, Command N on the Mac to bring up a new document panel, and I'm gonna size it with the website large 1920x1080. Click create. I already done my one, and as you can see, I have my color palette, which is very amazingly simple. So only two colors, orangey and this dark blue color. Okay, so grab the rectangle tool or click M on your keyboard and click on the free empty spot of your canvas to bring up a rectangle options. We need to size it with the width of 875, I believe it will be 75, and height of 780 pixels. Click OK to create this rectangle, and first of all I want to swap fill and stroke. Shift X or click on this kind of icon on the bottom of your toolbar. Next one, I need to align everything to the center, so make sure that you align into the artboard, and then I'm gonna work on the vertically and horizontally centered rectangle, and we need to create a grid, and one of the best option that I know is to split into grid. So go to the object, keep this rectangle selected, go to the object, then path, then split into grid with this ellipses, three dots in the end, and we need to bring up this grid. So number of rows 3, number of columns 3, no gutters. As you can see, Adobe Illustrator calculate everything for you, and click OK. Next one, you need to create another rectangle. This time we are going to just fill our top row, and I want to swap fill and stroke and grab the AirDropper tool or click I on your keyboard and select this orangey color. For those who following along, I want to read this color is F27E19, but I believe you will meet them into description. Okay, so for this scene, first of all, split it into another grid. So go to the object, path, and split into grid, and this time we need only the rows. So we need four rows, 65 pixels, as you can see, height of each. And the amazing thing about this split into grid options that you can, as you can see, you can select them one by one and delete, and basically I want to grab three of them, and I want to grab my shape builder tool and I want to combine them. You can also combine it by using this unite operation on the pathfinder panel. Okay, so we have two panels. Let me shift the hue a little bit so we can see what is going on. I want to shift the hue. We have these two panels, and one of the panels, frankly saying, is just a placeholder for our image. So we need to grab the image, and I find this wonderful site which called Wallpaper Access with this all of these oranges available for you for free. I'm not sure whether it's available for commercial products, so you need to read terms of use more carefully, guys. But I liked all of these collections, and at least I can show you how to work with them. So click this download button, then wait several seconds and click on this download full resolution image. You will get it. Let me get it as well. I want to just draw it in my page. Okay, so with this image, I want to align it kind of left to left with my placeholder and then shrink it down on one side. So it's kind of filling the width of my placeholder, right? The same way you are using, for example, in CSS, a background size color, right? Okay, let me put all of these two guys, placeholder and image, on the new layer. Okay, I'm working right now on the new layer. And first of all, I want to duplicate my placeholder with Ctrl-C, Ctrl-F and put it on top. And with this top placeholder and image selected, image of these oranges, I want to just use my right mouse button context menu and make clipping mask. So I have this clipping mask with the placeholder on the bottom. And now I want to select this clipping mask and go to transparency and adjust the color. As you may know, in Adobe Illustrator, we don't have the reliable tool that works with the raster images and allows you to adjust on the fly there, for example, the colors or the hue and saturation and all of this stuff. So my preferable way here is to work with the background image that gives you some color and work with the basically the blend mode. So what I need to do is to blend them with the appropriate mode. I need to find this mode, color bar. I found it already. And what you need to do next is to go to this placeholder. So this is the color bar net oranges and this is the placeholder. And placeholder just go introduce the transparency. And this will affect the kind of like prominence of your effect. So I don't think that my transparency should be more than 40, but this is how you can reliably adjust the color scheme and adjust it to the way you are. And now you can play with this 40% opaque image, adjusting in there for your oranges, right? Now we end up with oranges. You can even lock it on your layer. And I want to select and duplicate this border, right? This border on the bottom. And now we have definitely some space to allocate the text and some information about our product. I want to just, guys, in order to speed up obviously our tutorial, because I'm sure all of you know how to work with the text tool, I want to place all of this already in my image and just tell you that we are working here with the doses, which is the text for the product name, and everything else is open sans either light or semi bold. So this is it. This is the combination of our my typefaces, of my fonts. You may share your thoughts about this in the comments. What are your favorite fonts? But I think that this combination is working for me. I also want to play this, place this one. This one is simple ellipse with the diameter of 152 pixels. So for title, I'm using the doses 84 points. For the description, I use 28 points, and I also use the divider of the line with the 2 points and this color. Basically, as you can see, all of these elements that I show to you maintaining the same color, and this color is 143559. Click OK. Okay, so this one is also 28 points. But as you can see, I'm using Open Sans semi bold. The same as here, Open Sans semi bold, 28 points here. As you can see, they are kind of nicely fit inside my grid. As you can see, they are only, they use some small gaps here and there. Everything is aligned nicely. And what we need to do, I will show you how to create this orange just on the fly. So all in all, we started with this 152 pixels rectangle, and we need to grab this polar grid tool. I don't know whether you use it or not, but this polar grid is amazing. And what is amazing about polar grid? When you double click on it, you will see that you can set width and height. Again, we are interested in the 152. And then you can use concentric and radial dividers, so-called. So the concentric dividers will give you a lot of circles like this, and the radial dividers will give you the rays if it's the sun, right? So what we need to do is to set the concentric devices to zero, dividers to zero, and radial dividers to 8. Click OK. A scene, I want to grab this any color, it doesn't matter what color you are using, and align both of your tools. Now what you need to do, and this is one of the bugs that apparent in Adobe Illustrator, when you grab the shape builder tool or click shift M on your keyboard, you can see that these dividers don't work. So basically, to select the 8 divider, you need to create 16. Instead, you can use the direct selection tool, add a little bit, extend this ray, right? By first of all, you need to, of course, open this group, right? You need to go to this group. Now select all everything and go again to the shape builder tool. And now it's working like a charm. You need to select this sector and delete everything else. So before, you need to ungroup or Control Shift M and delete all of this stuff. So delete this one, and as you can see, you are dealing again with the group. Ungroup it again, select, and we have this sector, this slice of the orange. What you need to do next is to go to the object path and go to the offset path, and obviously you need to set the size offset size to -3 pixels to reduce it in the size a bit. But the offset path is amazing option for us because it doesn't delete the original file. So guys, because this original file is pointing to the center of all composition, right? But before we select the center of our composition and rotate everything, we need to a little smoothen the corners. And I'm working with the 1.2, guys. I'm working with 1.2 pixels, just like this. Keep this selected. You can swap fill and stroke, by the way. Keep this selected. Go to the rotate tool, grab the R in your keyboard, hold the Alt or Option on your Mac, and hit left mouse button key under the anchor, under the this tip of the point of this original file, to select the middle of this circle, right? And here we can use the even mass. We shouldn't know the exact angle. We are using the mass 360 divided with the forward slash, and then go to the 8, and then proceed with the top. So this is how you can use the mass in Adobe Illustrator. Click copy. It's important that you are clicking the copy, then Control D, Command D to fill all of these gaps, and it's looking amazing. And now you can delete the original file that pointing up on the center. Amazing, right? Now you can grab this tool and a little bit expand it to give the orange look, and go to the color. So we need to change the color in order to give it the resemblance with the orange. So this is how you can create this vector orange icon, and we need to obviously reduce it in size, place it here. And now I need to use the micronize, let me just copy it, flavonoid fraction. If it doesn't tell you anything, don't worry. it's normal scene, and we are using the 18 points, so this one is quite small, and I want to boost it a bit, I want to pull it on the top a bit, so just like this, it looks amazing, and we are done, we are ready to apply to our product. So what we need to do is to first grab our non-essential elements, and from non-essential elements I mean the grid. Now we are ready to squeeze our artboard and save our document as the PSD first of all. So go to the artboard, feed to artboard bones. Now we have our label and we good to go, we good to export it as. So export it as, choose PSD from this drop down. It's very important to save it to PSD if you're preparing it for a Photoshop, and use your like supplement mockup, right? Mockup. Click enter to export this. Here it just click OK, the containers of will be flattened. I don't think we need to lock these layers. Okay, and finally what I need to do is Ctrl Z to come back to normal mode and save it as Adobe Illustrator file as well, because this is how we need to save it if we want to design more option and make it adjustable. So let's place it on the plastic mockup again, guys. You can open it in Photoshop, just follow the link in the description, open your mockup. I've chosen this file, open it again, open recent. Yes, this is how it looks, guys. And then you need to go to the layer called replace. This is what we need to replace, so we just need to delete these pills and grab this vector smart object, go to the file and place embedded, right? Then go to the place when you save your PSD file. For me it's labels DOVN max PSD. When some small time, as you can see, I brought another mockup for some of the reason. It's even better. Why? Because PSD can preserve their layers, right, that you brought up in Adobe Illustrator. As you can see, everything is adjustable. And it's very important, guys, because you can change something on the fly. And what important for us, for example, for this particular model, that you can delete things that you don't want. You can save it. And now you can use Ctrl T and change their size. Don't forget that you don't need to use Shift in if you're working in Photoshop. Okay, so I kind of scale it up to fill almost every empty space here, and I want to shift it towards the left, so the left side will be occupied completely and the right side have this dramatic border. We need to close everything and apply the changes, and this is how you can change everything. And if you don't like the placement, guys, because placements is indeed important, you can go again and change a bit, introducing the some space on the left, then close it again, and this is how it works. So you can shift it backwards and forward. The middle position will be optimal here, so back and forth. So we are right now in the end of our product. This is how you can apply your label in Adobe Illustrator to the mockup. Okay, so next is to create our option with the logo. Yes, now I have this logo type on the left, this green endeavor, and we'll get something similar to this final option that I made in Adobe Illustrator. So let's get into it. Yes, we need the something to guide us, and it will be the grid. So I need to grab the grid on the top layer, and I need to put it on top of my image, just like this. So I have another panel, I have another section. I want to draw a rectangle in it, but before I want to select a new layer. So I want to create a layer that is below my grid. I want to fill it with the white rectangle, so it will be white with no border whatsoever. So click on this slash icon to delete the border. And now, guided by grid, I can safely put my my logo, right? My logo, and I will replace it to the new layer again. We can even write down that this is the logo, and let my eyes guide me in the positioning, right? Of course, if you will, you can position it like if you can align it via Adobe Illustrator as well. So far so good. It looks decent. We can delete this guides, everything, and save this document again. I want to save my time and save this ready-made image. So I want to save it again as the PSD. So export as PSD. I finally got this one. And let's open another mockup in Adobe Photoshop. And the next mockup, as you can see, doesn't show anything. It shows the layer that we need to delete. So don't worry about this. Just select this layer and hit backspace to delete it. You will see the mockup. And now let's enter inside. You will see the scene that we need to delete, but before we need to place our scene. Okay, so we need to let's go again to the place embedded or place linked, whatever you will. You need to fill everything here as much as you can. Click this button to apply the changes, position it in the middle, and let's finish and save the changes. And this is it. This is how you can create this variation with the mockup. Let's create the final result. And here I want to put a little bit more thought on it. Okay, and the last scene we will apply to this mockup with the pill and box in the same time. So let's rearrange the scenes. I want to create the last options, and I need these icons of varicose veins. I want to draw it on the new layer. So I want to create a new layer, scale it down considerably, so it will go to there. I want to also consider to change the style of my icons. I want to raise a bit the size of these arrows, both of them, and delete one of them. So it's obvious that we don't need one of the arrows. So now I want to change the position of this and this text. So let me go and quickly do it. And obviously I need to also reduce the size to 18. Put it in the middle. Same here. Put it in the middle. Set it to semi-bold. This one to semi-bold. Diosmin and Gesperidin to semi-bold. Let me move it a bit to the left, this title and subtitle. Make sure that this is in the middle of your grid cell. And finally this, I want to again use my rulers, grab the one of the ruler and put it on the bottom. And here I need to consider to reduce the size and make it semi-bold as well. Let me hide the grid and see how it looks like. It looks okay, but the text is not aligned and I have a couple of issues with the imaging. So I want to grab a ruler again, take the guide, put it in the side, align it with the protect my way in, and align both text. Now I want to delete the guide, see it again. This one is okie dokie. Okay, this one is far better. Now I want to save it again. And finally, with this option, I need to save it, export it as the PSD, right? PSD. Click export, click OK. It will take some while. And now go to the Photoshop and open this portal mockup. It is the last link in the description. And here we need to place both of them here. Design of the bottle, design of the, we can call it the box, right? So let's go there, paste your design here. So place embedded. And go to the supplement. What if I place it here and delete this design? Let's take a look. I want to place it in the middle. Okay, so we have our bottle placement. Let me change it a bit. I want to fill all of the space, horizontal space available for me, but as you can see I shouldn't exceed all these guys. So let's try it again. Let's change it again. Okay, it looks better. As for me, I don't know guys, what do you think about it? Let's place embed it again. Click OK, delete the fill and close the layer. Again, my thought on it that we need to fill all of the horizontal space for it to make some sense. It looks okay-ish for me. Basically, this is just one option for some of the things. I think it lacks some transparency. If we delete this field, the white field in the middle, I think it will be better, because as I told you, it is working on the transparent layer. So if we delete this white in the middle, it will be far better for our project. So this was the label design for the bottles, for the medical bottle. As you can see, what we done is that we designed the label in Adobe Illustrator, then created some variation and used three types of mockup for presenting it to your client. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you do, give it some bub, subscribe to my channel and share this tutorial with your friend. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to visit tutorial.net for more Adobe Illustrator and graphic designer tutorials, and have a nice day!